Hi there, folks, and thanks for joining us here on the web. Exit 18 on Interstate 89 is shut down. A truck hauling logging equipment actually brought down some power lines, and there's also a separate serious rollover crash. A viewer sent in these pictures from earlier. The road is expected to be shut down for some time, though, as state police do an accident reconstruction. Well, as you might imagine, the hot weather has a lot of people flocking to the beach. They started arriving there by about 8 o'clock this morning, and by 10, all the best real estate had already been staked out, and with the tide going in, that stretch of openness was just a bit of a tease, because by 3:30 this afternoon, less real estate. High tide hitting in the center of these hot days has been making for some packed afternoons. The water, though, still pretty chilly.
And it's warm and trying to stay cool.
Have you been in the water yet?
No. No.
You think you will?
No.
Oh yeah, I go in the water. Even though it's cold, you still have to get in it because it's too hot out here.
Our lifeguards are out in full force with a special beach vehicle that can apparently move pretty quick in the sand. And in addition to first aid kits, also carries a giant cooler of water. All right, we've just learned the name of the man who shot and killed himself after an hours-long standoff in Keene. Officers say they were trying to arrest 34-year-old Matthew Snow on a warrant when he pulled out a gun. Neighbors had to be evacuated and the SWAT team was called in. Snow shot himself after about 4 hours. He was rushed to the hospital, but later died of his injuries. A Manchester man who allegedly had videos depicting children engaged in sex acts went before a judge this morning. Warren Robinson, now charged with 30 counts of possession of child pornography, one for each video he allegedly had on his computer. Those videos, according to the affidavit, show children, including possibly a 4-year-old girl, being forced to perform sex acts on adults. His wife, Linda, says while her husband has always been curious, she had no idea that he was looking at child porn.
It's not like him to do that. It's really not. He's not that kind of a person. I swore up and down the whole time the police were here that he didn't do it. I'm like I said, you could have blown me over with a feather. I'm beyond shocked.
Well, Warren Robinson's bail was set at $30,000. He's now scheduled to be back in court on July 15th for a hearing on probable cause. Well, starting tonight at 5 o'clock, one New England state is trying a new way to protect EBT cards from being stolen. And did you know a key piece of gear in the World Cup games is being made right here in New England? We're going to show you what it is, but for now, that's going to do it for us. Be safe. Have a great afternoon.